Hello friends, I welcome you to EPG Pathshala. My name is Chef Jaswinder Singh and I am working as Assistant Professor in University Institute of Hotel and Tourism Management. Dear scholars, I would be taking module named as Stocks under the paper Food Production, Operations and Management. The primary objectives of this module would be identify various types of stocks used in the kitchens and classify them, know the preparation of various stocks and their usage, figure out the storage criteria of a stock, understand how to make a good quality stock. For good sauce and soups, one has to make good stock. Stock is a flavorful liquid which is obtained by prolonged simmering of bones, aromatic vegetables, along with herbs and spices. And the basic flavor can be fish, poultry, meat, or vegetable. Stock cubes are over salty and lack the intense flavor of properly made stock, making the food taste the same as an emergency measure or to strengthen a rather weak stock. They are very useful. But a good cook should be able to make a perfect stock. Stock can be simply defined as a liquid which has been simmered for a long time in order to extract the flavor from ingredients used. In almost all the cases, water is the liquid medium used in which flavor is extracted, and the same is passed and used accordingly. Stock is usually made from the bones and vegetables. The type of bones used for the stock would depend upon the final usage of a stock, and same way the name is suggested. Bones are porous and somewhere hard in nature, and hence prolonged amount of cooking at lower temperature is the best method of cooking stock. Vegetables are again soft in nature, so prolonged cooking would make the vegetables to go mushy and bitter as well. So it is never advised to simmer vegetable for longer than 45 minutes. When simmered, the impurities from the stock rises to the surface of the liquid and forms a layer of scum floating on top. So it is advised to keep removing the scum from time to time intervals during the time required to make a particular stock, or else stock would get cloudy and termed as cloudy stock. This is the most important part of the stock, as this will give a definite characteristic to the stock. A chicken stock simmered with Indian spices would be used only in Indian cooking. Chicken stock with Thai flavorings would be used only in Thai dishes. Similarly, Western stock would use herbs and other vegetables depending upon the type of stock. The bunch of herbs used in flavor Western stock is termed as bouquet garni. Certain spices such as bay leaf, peppercorn and dry thyme are used to spice up the stock and are known as sachet d'épices, literally means bags of spices. A stock should be flavored enough to allow it for easy identification, but the flavor should not be overpowering to mask the real flavor of the stock. General information and rules when making the stock. The secret of a perfect stock is slow, gentle, prolonged simmering. If the liquid is the slightest bit greasy, Vigorous boiling will produce a murky, fatty stock. Skimming, especially for meat stock, is vital. As fat and scum rise to the surface, they should be lifted off with a basting spoon. Rich brown stock are made by roasting or baking the bones, vegetables and scraps of meat until a good dark even brown. Only then does the cook proceed with the gentle simmering. Care must be taken not to burn the bones or vegetables. One burned carrot can ruin a pot of stock. Brown stocks are usually made from red meats and veal, but can be made with poultry. White stocks are more delicate and are made by simmering only. They are based on white poultry or vegetable or fish. The longer brown meat stocks are simmered, the better flavor they will be. A stock pot will simmer all day in a restaurant, being skimmer or topped up with water as the chef passes it, and only strained before closing time. However, it is very important not to just keep adding bits and pieces to the stock pot and to keep it going on the back burner for days, because the pot will become cluttered with cooked out bones and vegetables that have long since given up any flavor. At least 3 and up to 8 hours over the gentlest flame. Fish stocks should never be simmered for more than 20 minutes. After this, the bones begin to impart a bitter taste, flavor to the liquid. For a stronger flavor, the stock can be strained, skimmed of any scum or fat, and then boiled down to reduce and concentrate it. Vegetable stocks do not need long cooking, as they contain very little fat. Even if the vegetables have been browned before simmering, they are easily skimmed and can then be boiled rapidly after straining to concentrate the flavor. 30 minutes simmering is generally enough for vegetable stock. Now we discuss about the bones. Most households rarely have anything other than the cooked big bones from a roast available for stocks. These will make adequate stock, but it will be weaker than that made with raw bones. Raw bones are very often free from the butcher or can be had very cheaply. Get them chopped into manageable small pieces in the shop. A little raw meat, the bloodier the better, gives a rich, very clear liquid. Water. The water must be cold when you start the stock. If it is hot, the fat in the bones and will melt immediately, and when the stock begins to boil, much of the fat will be bubbled into the stock. The stock will then be murky, have an unattractive smell and nasty flavor. Cold water encourages the fat to rise to the surface. It can then be skimmed. Jellied stock. Veal bones produce a particularly good stock that will set to be a jelly. A calf foot added to any stock will have the same jellifying effect. Jellied stock will keep longer liquid stock, but in any event, stock should be reboiled every 2 or 3 days if kept refrigerated, or every day if kept in a larder, to prevent them going bad. Salt. Do not add salt to stocks. It may be used later for something that is already salty, or boiled down to a concentrate glaze. Glaze the viand, in which case the glaze would be oversalted if the stock contained salt. Salt does not boil off with the water, but remains in the pan. Storage. A good way of storing a large batch of stock is to boil it down to a syrupy consistency and to add water only when using. Freeze the glaze in ice cube trays and then turn the frozen cubes into a plastic box in the freezer. They will keep for at least a year if fat free. Equipments: you will need a large pot that can be used for the simmering of large quantities. Any size from a 10 liters to 20 liter pot will be sufficient. You will need a sieve to skim the stock and remove the impurities. At the end of the stock making process, you will need a large strainer and clean container to hold the full amount of liquid. Straining will leave you with a clear liquid. No debris or bones should be left in the liquid stock. Convenience emergency stock: you can buy ready-made powdered stock in any large retailer. These items have directions for use on all of the containers and can be used for all types of stocks, soups and sauces. Now we discuss about the recipe of brown stock, and the ingredients are 1 kg of bones of beef, veal or chicken, marrow bones, 2 medium onions unpeeled and cut into 8 through the root, 2 medium carrots peeled and cut into 2.5 cm pieces, 2 sticks of celery cut into 2.5 cm pieces, 1 turnip cut into 2.5 cm pieces, small celery egg peeled and cut into 2.5 cm pieces, 110 grams of button mushroom which is crushed, 1 bulb of fennel sliced, 2 tablespoon vegetable oil, 1 tablespoon tomato paste, 2 liters of cold water, handful of fresh parsley stalks, 1 bay leaf, teaspoon of black peppercorns, 1 sprig of fresh thyme. And the method is: preheat the oven to 220 degrees centigrade. Trim any excess fat from the bones, place in a roasting tray and roast in the oven for about 1 hour until a rich russet brown. Turn the bones occasionally to ensure that they roast and brown evenly on all sides. During the browning process, most of the remaining fat will melt and collect in the roasting tray. Shallow fry the vegetables in the vegetable oil until they are caramelized to a rich golden brown. It is essential that they do not burn. Add the tomato puree to the vegetable just before they are fully browned to caramelize it to a deeper red brown color. Remove any burnt vegetable pieces as they will taint the stock with a bitter flavor. Place the bones and vegetable in a deep narrow pot and cover with cold water. Bring slowly to the boil, skimming the scum off occasionally as it rises to the surface. There should be little fat as most of it was rendered down during the roasting and browning process. When the water comes to poach, pour cold water into the pot to solidify the fat and scum and skim well to remove the fat and scum, ensuring that the remaining liquid is as clear as possible. Add the remaining ingredients. Add more cold water to cover the ingredients. Then bring back to the boil. Poach the ingredient for 4 to 5 hours for the chicken bones and 5 to 6 hours for beef bones, skimming occasionally. Strain the stock, but do not press the vegetables in the sieve as this could make the stock cloudy. Reduce the stock to the required strength, skimming regularly. to store the stock, reduce to a glaze, then cool. Now we discuss about chicken stock. Same ingredients as for the beef stock, but only use chicken bones and veal knuckle bones forms the jelly, which forms the jelly. Do not place the chicken bones in the roasting pan. They are too soft and will become brittle. Glaze the viand. Use brown stock, absolutely free of fat, in a heavy saucepan. Reduce the brown stock by boiling over a steady heat until thick, clear and syrupy. Pour into small pots. When cooled, cover with cling film. Keep in the refrigerator until ready for use. Co bouillon. Ingredients are 1 liter of cold water, 150 ml of white wine vinegar, 200 ml white wine, 1 carrot sliced, 1 onion sliced, 1 stick of celery, 12 black peppercorns, 2 bay leaf and salt. Method: place half of the water with all of the ingredients in a large saucepan and simmer for 20 minutes. Simmer for 20 minutes, add the remaining water and allow to cool and strain. Standard recipe of fish stock. Number of portion 2 liters. And the ingredients are fish trimmings 500 grams, mirepoix, sachet d'epices, bouquet garni, 2 carrots 150 grams, onions 75 grams, leeks 50 grams, celery 25 grams, garlic 10 grams, parsley stem 10 grams, fresh thyme 3 sprig, bay leaf 2 numbers, black peppercorns 2 grams, cloves 2 numbers, lemon 1 number, butter 15 grams, water 2.5 liters. And the method is, melt butter in a pan and saute fish trimmings along with herbs, spices and other vegetables with lemon juice for a minute. Add water and bring to a boil stage. Let it simmer for 20 minutes and sieve carefully. For better and clearer stock, do not use fish trimming with lot of fat or flesh. Keep on skimming the stock in between. Standard recipe of white meat stock. Number of portion 1 liter and the ingredients are blanched bones 1 kg, mirepoix, sachet d'epices, bouquet garni, carrot 100 grams, onions 80 grams, leeks 50 grams, celery 50 grams, garlic 10 grams, parsley stem 10 grams, fresh thyme 3 sprig, bay leaf 2 leaves, black peppercorns 2 grams, clove 2 numbers, water 4 liter. And the method is, blanch bones in boiling water for 1 minute and then refreshed and wash bones nicely. In a clean vessel, add fresh cold water and vegetables and bring to a boil. Let it simmer for 3 hours. Add spices and further simmer for 40 minutes. Sieve carefully and chill the stock to remove any frozen fat floating on top or use. Standard recipe of vegetable stock. Number of portion 3 liters. And the ingredients are main vegetable trimmings 1 kg, mirepoix, sachet d'epices, bouquet garni, carrots 150 grams, onion 50 grams, leeks 50 grams, celery 30 grams, garlic 10 grams, parsley stem 10 grams, fresh thyme 3 sprig, bay leaf 2 numbers, black peppercorns 2 grams, clove 2 number, water 3.5 liters. And the method is, add everything in a water except spices and bring it to boil. Simmer and add spices. Simmer for more 30 minutes and sieve. Important terms, broth, known as bouillon in French. It is a result of poaching meat or vegetables in a liquid medium. Gros bouillon, water boiled with seasoning and flavoring with an acidic medium such as wine or lemon juice is called as gros bouillon. Neutral stock, it is usually referred to a veal stock which is white in color and has a neutral flavor. Fumé, fish stock is called fumé in French. Many people confuse it with glaze, which means a reduced fish stock. Remoulade, it is also known as rewetting of the second stock. When the stock is made and strained off, more water is added to the remaining bones and vegetables, and the stock is simmered for around an hour. Standard Mirepoix, 50% of onion, leeks, 25% of carrot, turnips, 25% of celery root, sachet d'epices, 1 sprig thyme plus 1 bay leaf plus 3 to 4 parsley stems plus 5 grams of peppercorns, optional, 1 garlic for 4 liters of water. Bukegani, 1 sprig thyme plus 1 bay leaf plus 1 by 6 of celery stick, 1 by 6 of leeks for 4 liters of water. Usage of stock. Stocks are usually used generally in making of soups and thickened to form sauces. Some stocks are reduced and used as a glaze to give shiny appearance on top of certain food items. Some cold foods are also simmered with glaze. Aspic jelly is also made by reduction of stock and is transparent amber color in nature. And different cutouts are made with the help of cutters to garnish certain food like chaufroa and smoked fish, which is being served cold. Stocks are the base for any Western cooking. Most commonly, it is used to make soup and sauces. But the usage is not just limited to this. White stock are used in preparation of white sauces and clear soup, while brown stocks are used in brown sauces. Red meat stews and braised dishes. Stock can also be used to prepare certain rice dishes such as paella and biryanis. Care and precautions. Golden rule is to simmer, not to boil. Always simmer the stock for extraction of better flavor. No green leaf from celery stick should be added to avoid discoloration of stock. Use of proper timing is always very important. Blanching of bones in hot water is very important. Before you make white stock of bones, always roast the bones to an even brown color and not to burn them. Do not stir while simmering, as few vegetables get mushy, and while stirring they get mashy and make the stock cloudy. Add sachet d'epices at later stages so that spices doesn't overpower the flavor and aroma of main ingredient used. Important related terms are consommé, espagnol, estufad, fondue cuisine, velouté, shorba, shin bones, ragout, broth, and gros bouillon. And the conclusion is, the first stock were simple broth that were the byproduct of poached meats and fish dishes before the method of preparing stock was refined. Cooks often braised or roasted meat with a thick slice of ham or veal to give the sauce extra body. Stocks are the beginning of many sauces. One can make one basic stock, divided into two or three portions, and flavor each portion with different herbs or vegetables to make three different stocks or sauces. Since stocks are often more intensely flavored than the food they accompany, one must prepare them with the best available ingredients. And the traditional recipe for stocks are divided into white and brown. White stocks are prepared by blanching meat and bones in water, whereas brown stock are prepared by first roasting or browning the bones in the oven, which result in a deep amber color and a rich flavor. Brown stock can be used as the base for reduction of sauces and stews. One can use white stock in place of water in many savory recipes or as a base for soups and sauces. The most common white stock encountered in the kitchen are veal stock, chicken stock, and fish stock. However, in India, chicken stock is used as a neutral stock. Thank you so much.